I hardly got through this album. I got through it once. And I'm like, okay, he got some joints on here.
Yeah, some joints on here.
It's some solid joints on here. It's one of the better Khaled albums.
It honestly is.
Yo! Welcome to Beers and Bars, your place for rapid fire hip hop discussion and, of course, great beer.
I'm Kamal Kiddo.
OT the Golden Child. Y'all see what time it is, man. Thanks for checking out last week's episode.
Yeah, back with
a new episode. This is episode 121 or 122?
122.
122.
Yeah.
Let's get right into our topics for this week.
Man. Oh, wow. Yeah, okay. What are our topics, man?
We're going to do all album reviews this week. We all laid album reviews. I think we laid on one of them because I think the DJ Khaled. Well, no, not really.
Like, no, Khaled and Tyler dropped.
Yeah.
A time ago at this point. Yeah, a couple weeks ago.
Okay.
YG just dropped.
Right.
Not too long ago.
Okay.
After Tyler and Khaled. Right.
So it's Khaled.
And that's what we're talking about.
Father of Asahd, right?
Khaled's father of Asahd, DJ Khaled. Another one.
We the best. Tyler the Creator.
Tyler the Creator, IGOR.
Uh-huh.
And YG.
For real, I believe, right?
Yeah. Dedicated to Nipsey Hussle. But that's like under.
Exactly.
That's like under the joint.
Yeah.
For real. You're right.
Yep.
What are we drinking?
This week we are going to be drinking Firestone Walker's Mine Haze. We've had the pack from them before, the one time we was at Air Crib. We had the Union Jack IPA, and we had another lager and something else out of there. It was a stout or a porter, I think. Anyhow, we also have
Where are they located?
I believe they out in Cali, man. I'm almost positive.
We gonna have to travel there.
Yeah, well, we need to just go there in general because I want to go there. But I was trying to drink Lagunitas this week. Their summer pale or something like that. I forgot which one it is. Because I wanted to do a pairing with something. And the pale ale, it said you should pair them with cheddar, but I found out you can also pair IPAs with, you know, certain cheeses as well. This is a mild cheddar we have here. I just wanted
look at this tray that OT set up, man.
I just wanted a reason to eat cheese and drink beer, to be honest with you. But
look at this tray.
This joint was at like it had some good reviews on Beer Advocate. This beer.
True.
Coming in at 6.2% alcohol volume.
I'm a little congested. Do I sound that way? Let me go ahead and say that now. Because my voice is I feel real nostrilly.
Very light body.
I can hardly smell this.
Yeah. Very light body here. But I like them.
That's refreshing.
Their pack that we had, all the beers in their pack that we had got that one time. It was four different ones in there. Were pretty good. I know they do their thing out there on the West Coast.
And why do we pair this with cheese?
Mm-hmm. I went online to see what was the best pairing for IPAs, and I kept seeing sharp cheddars. Mainly, though, what you should do, I think, was like spicy cheddars. I guess it opens it up even more, but I'm not sure.
Interesting.
But I saw sharp cheddar. A different variation of cheddars. I think any kind of cheddar would go with an IPA. I don't know.
Is this a sharp cheddar right there?
Mm-hmm. Let's see.
I'm just eating the cheese.
Yeah.
I probably should be while congested. Respect to the show, Beers and Bars. I do it for y'all.
I like eating cheese. I like cheese and wine, cheese and anything. I'll pretty much, yeah. Give me cheese. All right.
You sound like Urkel.
Yeah, I know, right?
Cheese! All right. What we doing first?
Let's go ahead and go with, let's do DJ Khaled.
Let's all go ahead and get DJ Khaled out the way.
That's funny as hell.
All right, so DJ Khaled.
This is
major
third or fourth.
Personality.
Huh? Third or fourth?
Third or fourth what?
Okay.
Album?
I'm tweaking. Well, the actual releases.
He got major releases, G. He got major label releases, G, for some years now.
Well, I'm thinking it's like the fourth one.
No. No, he got years. Okay. Years.
Okay.
You know, DJ Khaled been around.
Well, yeah, I know he been around. Yeah.
It's like, I remember the first time I saw Shotta's like a couple years ago. Fact. And DJ Khaled was in it.
Been doing it for a while.
You know what I'm saying? That blew me away. But you know how Khaled do. He come with these joints.
Mm-hmm.
And his last two albums,
The last one was Grammy nominated.
Yeah, he's always gonna have something that's Grammy nominated. Like, right. That was that Rihanna song.
Yeah.
Which I hated. You know what I'm saying?
Wow thoughts.
Yeah. Like, it's becoming his thing to do the same beat of a popular song long ago.
Yeah, I don't know why he
did. So like on this joint, he got
the scissor joint.
The scissor joint is Miss Jackson.
Yeah, I don't like that at all.
It's growing on me. I ain't gonna lie.
Irritated the hell out of me coming on because it's not Miss Jackson.
I agree with you, and that's the weird thing about it. I agree, but
because it's not
I'm
even like
I'm starting to like. I'm starting to like that song.
It's not even like a sample. He just takes the song and then just like does a remix, which that's his thing. Yeah. That's fine.
But, which is weird though. You know what I'm saying? But also he just giving you which I do like also.
Mm-hmm.
The Puffy joint.
Yeah.
Meek Mill and Lil Baby.
That joint fire.
That joint.
And that's the thing.
We gonna get it right.
He has joints to me.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, like, I think it comes on good, to be honest.
It does.
I rock with this joint. The Holy Mountain joint that it starts out with, I like this joint.
He got joints.
This joint decent to me. But then he do have them joints that's poppy, like the Jealous joint with Chris Brown, you know, that's...
I mean, yeah.
But it's still, it's going, you know.
But see, that's the thing, DJ Khaled...
He's out to make hits, right? He's out to make hits.
Yeah. He a DJ.
Exactly.
He still goes by DJ Khaled. He's not an artist.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? In that way.
Yeah.
He does it, like, yeah, he be in the studio with producers putting together a compilation.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
More so though, I think a lot of times what happens is that he contacts artists and he lets them know that he's working on something, and then maybe they send him joints that aren't even like that, maybe didn't make their
maybe. But I do know that he does, like, he does produce beats with producers. So he'll
get to sound, puffs it out, right? Yeah,
right. And the whole, are the vocals in yet?
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I hope.
Yeah.
That he's getting, you know what I'm saying, he's contacting artists to hire him to be on his song.
Yeah. I think Cass be sending him some songs, but
maybe.
I like this joint as well. I like the Celebrate joint. I like Travis Scott.
I like this joint.
Travis Scott and Post Malone, right?
Mm.
I rock with it. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
I rock with this joint, man. And then other than that, got a good Jeezy and Rick Ross joint.
Yeah.
Classic Jeezy. And I dig Ross, man.
Yeah, Ross my does favorites, this thing man. On here. Yeah.
My favorites.
Yeah.
If you've checked out this album, let us know what you think. You know what I'm saying? DJ Khaled, son of Asahd. No.
Father of Asahd.
Father of Asahd.
His son.
Yes. What's next? Let's take it out west, man.
I'm happy we're not rating albums anymore.
Yeah.
It would be hard to rate that.
It would be because it has Khaled joints.
It's got like singles. It's got a bunch of songs.
Exactly. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? They don't go together other than the fact that they're on that Khaled is he's the one putting them together.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
What is the most cohesive compilation that you think you have heard? It might be Soul
Survivor. That's a good question. But
because I think those guys were actually in the studio together making cohesive projects.
Before I give my answer, I'm going to be fair, and I thought about this before coming here, and I'm happy you said that because I thought about that.
I'm great.
With this album.
Mm-hmm.
Thinking, you are great, because I'm going to have to say, we might be on the same wavelength with that, G, because I meant to say it, but didn't, but now can say, well, what compilation is good? Well, there are some fire soundtracks, but and those are compilation of songs that go very well together, but let's be fair and look at compilations, specifically rap compilations, because soundtracks, well, I mean, that's a different vibe altogether. You know what I'm saying? It's a soundtrack.
Yeah.
But there have been some good compilations, I guess. Like, I don't know, man. Like some that I can stand, but I don't know how. I don't know, man. For me right now, off the top of my head, Sound Bombing 2 by Raucous Records holds a very strong space for me.
Okay. That might be in 99, right?
I think
when
so.
We review it, I believe.
99, 2000,
yeah. 98.
I don't know.
I think it's 99,
right,
man. I believe so.
But Sound Bombing 2 is a very good rap compilation, G.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
I mean, it's got... It's a whole feel through the thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's put together by...
You can tell those artists.
DJs. Like, or whatever. Two DJs mixed it.
Yeah.
So it's like... It's got a real DJ... DJ scratching vibe on it. Mm-hmm. String through the whole thing.
Yeah.
It's a good... And besides that, the song... Are good.
Yeah.
I may be overlooking. Well, I mean, I don't know. Rock Live Familia is pretty good.
Yeah, the Dynasty joint is pretty good too. Yeah.
The Dynasty joint is pretty good.
They cheated though, because that's a record label.
It's still a compilation.
Yeah.
The rap. I remember the rap side of the Pay the Full joint.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because it was a double disc.
Yeah.
And damn, the rap side of it. The rap side of it was pretty cool.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But, I don't know. Sound Bombing might be one of my top.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? That's, bruh.
Let us know what you think. What's your favorite compilation?
Speaking of, so now we off Khaled.
Yeah.
All right. What's next?
Let's go to For Real YG.
Ooh, yeah. All right, fair enough. I could have did YG last, but fair enough. YG, West Coast.
Yeah.
Very, you know what, like, people told me about, like, one of the first projects he put out. I don't know if Steel Brazy or something like that.
I believe it was. It might have been.
But somebody was telling me that it was really good.
My
and
Crazy
I never
Life?
Listened to it. Yeah, like, My Brazy Life.
Yeah.
Somebody was telling me like that was really good.
Yeah. Steel Brazy was 2016. Yeah.
So My Brazy Life is the first one.
I think so. Yeah. That was 20. Yeah. That was 2015, I think.
So people were telling me like, yo, you should check that. It's pretty solid.
Yeah.
I'm like, I never really listened to it.
Yeah.
There was a couple of singles on there, but I never really listened to it.
Mm-hmm.
Then his second one came out. People said it was good. But people told me the first one was really good.
Yeah.
All Mustard. Mm. Then I heard the Stay Dangerous joint from last year. And then this joint.
Mm-hmm.
Last joint, I was like, you know what? I kind of mess with YG. Like, I feel his vibe. This joint, I really like this joint.
I rock with dude. I'm going to tell you right now.
And I recognize his voice and his place in the culture, G.
Yeah.
He, no one raps like him. And he ride on beats, G.
Yeah.
Like, he got a... G, he don't have the same flow on a lot of these songs, G.
Yeah.
He switch it up.
Yeah.
And it's like, bruh.
What you going
to wait
do?
A minute, man.
Hard bottoms and white socks. Kick it off fire.
Hard... Bottle service is hard. Yeah. Treated the guys with G-Shocks. I still like my G-Shocks, though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I guess I'm broke because I be rocking the G-Shocks.
I don't know. Whatever.
But Go Loco.
Yeah.
He had the best verse. Stop Snitching. Mm-hmm. Classic West Coast vibe.
Yeah.
YG being playful, but at the same time, a good song. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I was on the block with Valet.
Fire.
That joint is fire, G.
Yeah. Let me see.
Valet and
Yeah. Yeah.
Bruh, this went on in a club, in a car, anywhere. This joint is like, ooh.
Play Too Much.
Ooh.
Fire.
Ooh.
Heart to Heart. Ooh. I like that joint. Her Story, I think, is dope.
Oh, yeah. Keisha Had a Baby.
Yeah.
Yeah, Heart to Heart. Yeah, G. It's,
I'm going to tell you like this.
There's a lot of good joints on here, G. And I'm just saying, like, this album, excuse me, I'm noticing his flow versatility, G.
Yeah.
And like, just how he delivers, like, he a good artist.
He's a very good artist, man.
He's a unique artist.
What I appreciate the most about him is that he's unapologetic from the standpoint of that he is West Coast gangsta. Hey, this need to be censored. Like he's in the vein of those guys from out west that just give you that straight. Because gangsta music was born with the NWAs and all that very raw, uncut. He just raw and uncut. He give it to you how he gives it to you. And I appreciate that, man, coming from out west. But it's different though, like you were saying.
Yeah.
He doing his own thing. He has his own flows. He has his own voice. This is one of the better albums right now of the year for right now for me.
Wow.
I just appreciate that it's different from anything and that he's doing what he do. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, he keeping it West Coast in the vein of a Cube, Easy.
He got some real West Coast.
He got some West Coast and he's West Coast himself. Like,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? He gonna drop bitch 35,000 times and you know what I'm saying? Like, but that was born out there like that. That stuff that's gonna make people be like, this is just too much.
Yeah.
But that's where it was born at. You know what I mean? So.
But it's like, it's in a time good. In 2019 when rap like this can make people upset and groups will try to make you apologize
that's
for certain lyrics.
That's why I like him.
It's unapologetically West Coast.
Mm-hmm.
Hood, G.
And that's what I appreciate about it.
You know what I'm saying? And this is probably not the hardest he been, G.
No.
You know what I'm saying? This is probably not the hardest we've heard from YG,
yeah.
G. I haven't heard his first. Yeah, like this extra
classic,
West Coast.
G. This is classic West Coast, G. I'm tearing this cheese up right now. Cuz. What you mean, cuz? Bruh.
Baby girl was 5'9", she was bad and running shit.
Bruh, slick, that bounce.
All the time, she'll pull up real quick. She had me feeling I'm special shit. We always talk about
yeah, man. Check out YG, man. You ain't checked this album out yet, you sleep.
I'm checking for it, man.
You are beyond me right now, not checking out this album.
I'm checking for it.
Yeah. What are we doing? Wanna start or stop or you wanna go to them?
Let's keep moving.
Okay. Final album. Final. Fight. What we doing?
Tyler the Creator.
Uh-huh.
Also from the West Coast.
Yeah.
IGOR.
Told y'all West Coast was running it. Look, here.
They making a resurgence, man.
Man, West Coast been killing it for some years, my
guy. For real this time.
So Tyler the Creator.
For real.
IGOR.
For real this time.
Just like a landscape of like, for me,
oh, you mean my earthquake.
Out the gate, this joint come on nasty.
So first of all, I hardly do social media.
Yeah.
And like, I don't follow no celebrities like that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But I check for Tyler.
Mm-hmm.
Because he's very, all of his, like, output.
He's interesting. He's an interesting dude, man.
Is, like.
An artsy and.
Yeah, G. He's all the stuff Tyler. That I mess with, G.
He's just tired.
Cartoons.
Man. Yeah.
Interesting music videos, G.
Yeah.
Like, they not just, like, it's like some thought put into him.
Well, he's an artist, man.
Art pieces, like, he a real artist,
he's
right?
He's an artist, dog.
So we already know that one of his biggest influences in music is Pharrell.
And you hear it all on it. You just...
And you definitely have heard it in other albums. Yeah. Like, if you check for Tyler.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Right now, for me, at first when I heard the joint, I didn't, like, there were songs that I liked instantly.
Mm-hmm.
But towards the middle, I'm like, eh, I don't know about this joint. And then I heard it again. And then I heard it again.
Yeah.
And then I heard it again. It
grows, yeah.
And then now I notice myself only wanting to hear it.
That's the mark of a good album, though.
I've heard Khaled once all the way through. And I give everything twice.
Yeah.
And I've heard it like 1.5 times through. Gee, as far as like those two dropped on the same day,
mm-hmm.
Khaled and Tyler.
Yeah.
And Tyler, G. He put together a project, G.
He did.
You know what I'm saying?
Like, are we still friends?
Arrangements. Yeah. He did everything, G?
I don't know, but I
believe
so.
Besides, like, maybe some musicians.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
But this is his brain, though.
Yeah, G. He orchestrated this whole thing. Well, and I love the fact that it's hidden singers and whatnot.
Yeah.
And it's not like credited on there. It's like they helping with the process. Like those albums
people
we doing
that
dude.
A lot now, man. People is
people been doing
Astro
that a lot.
World, right?
Yes,
way
Astro
back
World.
When he dropped
with Yeezus.
Pimp a Butterfly. Well, actually you're right. Even Yeezus.
And Pimp a Butterfly, yes.
But I'm sorry, no.
Like that. I like
Pablo,
that.
Pablo.
I like that feel. Yeah. Pablo too.
But hold on, just when an album come on like this right here, G, first of all. Bruh. But that's not even.
And this Uzi.
Really?
Yep.
But hold on, that's not even. Just. I gotta talk about the end of the song, G. I'ma crack a beer.
True.
Cause they playing music at the end of this song.
Yeah. Uzi.
Psst. Bruh. Going out with the pianos and whatnot. I think I might have missed it. Wait, hold on.
Woo! That's what I'm saying, like, this has got an energy to it. This has got an energy to it. So I follow him on Twitter, right? And he got a tweet that went, I don't even know what genre to put this in, right?
Yeah, figure it out.
And I thought about that too. They gonna put it in rap because he's a rapper.
Of course.
You know what I'm saying? Like, what do you put 808 to Heartbreaks in?
Mm-hmm.
He ain't rapping on there at all.
Mm-hmm.
He got rappers on there. He got Jeezy and Wayne on there, but yeah. He ain't rapping on there.
Yeah.
But anyway, but he's a rapper, right?
Yeah.
But I would call it dance, G.
It probably
for me,
is.
You know what I'm saying?
I think I would. But
everything is a jam, G.
Yeah.
Everything is a jam. But, and then on top of that, it's a story in it, G.
Mm.
It's a linear story, G.
Mm.
He liked somebody, he fell in love, he fell out of love.
Yeah.
He fell in love, he fell out of love.
How about this? Fun fact.
Playboi Carti, we're hard on there to me, G.
Fun fact, I saw this somewhere. This song was originally written for Justin Timberlake and Rihanna.
Earthquake?
Yes. You guys looked it up. I saw. I
wow.
I'm not sure what they.
That I wonder if that would have got him more money than putting it on his own joint, G.
Well, here's the thing about it, though. And what I'm noticing as to why I can see they was like, okay. Like, this is a great Tyler song. Like, it's a good, like, just dope album cut, whatever. If you could,
but Justin anybody could have, look, That's the thing, though. Anybody could sing this song, though, G.
No, it wouldn't have been. But when you get Timberlake and Rihanna together, it has to be like a...
That's true. That's a thing. That's
it has to be like whatever is going to be globally hitting. You know what I'm saying?
You. I feel you.
So...
I feel you.
But yeah.
It's a good song. It's a good song for Tyler. Hey, man. I'm happy he's getting all this recognition right now.
It really is, man.
Because right now, his star is rising because people feeling this album, G. Yeah. It's like double what on the Billboard charts.
Yeah. That's dope.
Like number one.
That's dope.
Not like on the Billboard. Not like just on the Billboard charts.
Yeah.
Number one on the Billboard charts.
That's dope.
Look that up, bro.
First of all. Samples. That's fire. This is like yay, but like not yay.
But that's the thing. That's the great thing about
you hear
yay.
You hear his influences.
For real, like. He is a child of those artists, you know what I'm saying, that opened the door for this.
Yeah.
And he's going to open the door for somebody else to do what he do.
Yeah.
Because wouldn't be no Tyler without somebody like a Pharrell or a Kanye, G.
That's true.
That's into other artistic things, G. Yeah. And open the door for him to be able to do everything that he doing, G.
Yeah.
And is interested in and thought
that's true.
He could do. You know what I'm saying? That's why he's able to make a project like this, G. Bruh, this hard.
This
and
fire,
it's got, man. And you can definitely hear his influence.
Yeah.
But. And, yay on this joint.
Is he on this one, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
G, the thing is, like, listening to it, I wouldn't know none of that unless I actually hadn't read it.
Mmm.
Like, I'm like, dang, G, that is yay, but I ain't even, like, really paying no attention.
Yeah. Well, because you're just paying attention to how dope the music is.
Yeah. Like, it's not like, it's layers to it, G.
Yeah.
It's like, bruh.
Have you checked out this album? This is my joint, too. See, that's the type of stuff, bruh.
And it's like not even perfect pitch singing.
Yeah.
It's like just an emotional feel. It's a vibe. It's a feel, G.
Yeah.
It ain't even perfect pitch singing, G.
It's very, I'm not going to compare it to nothing. I'm going to just let it live where it is.
Yeah, I like it.
I'm not going to make no comparison.
I like it a lot. It's up there for me right now.
For this year?
Yeah. Yeah. It's kind of knocking Solange out right now.
You know what's so funny is that they're not the same, but it's from an artistic standpoint and just putting together some great cohesive art that you can't really, like, what is Solange really doing? Like, it's R&B, but at the same time, it's not your traditional.
It's very experimental. Dude.
Exactly. And this is what this is.
It's very avant-garde.
Yeah.
Like, for real. Like, she put together a real R&B avant-garde album, G.
Yeah, for sure.
It's not like
for sure
your normal album.
Yeah.
But these songs he put together, he composed, other artists can perform them.
Yeah.
Other artists will perform Earthquake.
Mm.
Watch people doing acoustic joints of Earthquake, probably out right now already on YouTube.
Mm.
Bruh, other people can perform these songs.
Yeah.
G, he put together a solid album, G.
Mm.
And it's a solid concept album.
Yeah.
It's about love, G.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
What's the IGOR significance?
IGOR, I don't completely, I mean, maybe that's just the character.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I've been trying to figure that out, but I don't know. But that's good, though, because that leaves you up your conspiracies and thoughts of, this is what, and that's what artists do. Because I'm pretty sure people have whole broken down, no, this is what IGOR is, and that's what's dope.
We ain't got to get into that.
I mean, we don't, but I mean, people, that's what's dope about stuff like this, like IGOR.
Yeah. Like, I just think that, I ain't thought about it too much, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
I just feel like the album itself is
fire.
Is good.
Check out Tyler the Creator. IGOR.
It's good.
Check out DJ Khaled.
Oh, let me say one more thing.
That and all that, another out, YG for real too.
As far as Tyler is concerned,
yeah,
I check for this artist right now. For me, Wolf is his best album in my opinion. You know what I'm saying?
First
Wolf, his second official album, his third album though, his third work though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
Wolf. Hard, good, rap, beats, good. This is up there though, G. Like there couldn't have been a Flower Boy without Cherry Bomb. Cherry Bomb to me wasn't that good.
I love Flower Boy, man.
But Flower Boy was decent, but it wasn't. It was decent to me, but it wasn't like. Not it wasn't all the way, but this joint, there couldn't have been an IGOR without a Cherry Bomb, and a Flower Boy,
right?
Because Cherry Bomb, you started to see him get more compositional as far as like his music. You know what I'm saying? He started to make more songs.
Yeah.
Not just rap songs, but more like singy songs. You know what I'm saying? At Cherry Bomb.
Yeah.
So, you know, he's starting to do that even more on Flower Boy.
Yeah.
And then IGOR is mostly, it's a love story. Like, it's like, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, G.
Yeah.
I just wanted to say that real quick. I still think Wolf is his best album. But IGOR is definitely... Bastard is a solid album for him, and I will have to listen to it again before I say it's number two.
Yeah.
To IGOR is number three, but right now I could put IGOR as number two. Because I like him as the artist, and I care about his music. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Wolf is up there.
Yeah.
And then IGOR, possibly. I got to listen to Bastard again.
Okay.
But yeah, Jay. Also, though, check out Flying Lotus.
I need to. The electronic drum. I did not yet.
Flamagra?
That's a good point. Good shit.
Flamagra?
Good shit. Flamagra? I definitely saw it drop and I wanted to.
I've been listening to it, but I got other albums to listen to because of the show.
I checked for dude, though.
But on the way to the crib, I'm going to be listening to bro.
You
got some joints out here.
You check out the Beast Coast joint? Check for Beast Coast?
Yeah, I checked it.
Was it
oil? My homie Nick sent it to me. It's got some joints on there.
I'm gonna check because I work with a lot of artists from Beast Coast. So I'm gonna check.
Yeah. Beast Coast. Right. Other things to check out.
Yeah.
Flying Lotus got a new joint.
Yeah.
And Beast Coast being who's in it?
Beast Coast. All those cast the
Pro Era.
Pro Era. Joey Badass. CJ Flies at Beast Coast.
Underachievers.
Right? Is that CJ Fly?
I'm not sure. Yeah, he's in it.
I believe so, yeah.
He did it for sure.
Yeah.
But yeah, I can't remember everybody in it.
Okay.
But yeah.
Check them out. Beers and Bars, we at the Brewfest?
Yes, we are at Brewfest.
Okay. Sunday, we'll be there. 12 to 4. That's when we have.
Ooh,
yeah, right, yeah.
We have
passes for that.
We should have passes. You'll see us there.
Yeah.
In our Beers and Bars regalia.
Yeah, man. Come holler at us. We'll see y'all next week, man.
Peace.
Yeah.